recently, I ordered a very special and historic postal cover for my postal history collection. And actually, it wasn't scheduled to arrive until tomorrow, but it actually arrived today. And so I wanted to show it to you as I open it. I am actually going to be doing a more detailed video on the history of the... this isn't it. This is the envelope that came in. It comes in. On the history of the piece, which is really significant to Michigan history. So I'm going to set the camera down here because I don't have a tripod available. And I'm just going to slice this open real quick and carefully. They've got it really taped up, but I wanted to show you the item because it is very significant historically in Michigan. It is a stampless postal cover from 1839, and before the United States issued postage stamps, they would actually stamp the value on the envelope, or usually it was just to fold it over a letter, and then the person receiving the letter had to pay the postage rather than the person sending the letter, and that was the way it was done. But the significant thing about this piece is Michigan's capital, which is now in Lansing, was at this time in Detroit, and our governor was the boy governor, Stephen T. Masons. And there's a signature on the back of this, which is actually, I believe, is the governor's signature. Now I'm going to open this. Here we go. There is the cover. Let me get it out of the glare. It was addressed to Henry G. Hubbard, Esquire. Hubbard is a very prominent name in Michigan history, but this was going to Connecticut, I believe it is. There is on the back. Now see, it has the red. Well, let me take it out of here first. A second. Sorry about. Okay. It has the red Detroit cancellation, and it is from 1839. Excuse me. On the reverse is Governor Mason, 1839, December 14th. From what I've been able to tell on the internet, that is the governor's signature. Okay, there is no letter. There was would have been a letter in it, of course, at one time, naturally. But a beautiful, beautiful postal cover. Kind of on the costly side. One of the more expensive pieces in my postal history collection. But I just wanted to show it to you. As I was taking it out, I am absolutely pleased and totally delighted that I was able to obtain that piece. And I obtained it on eBay from Amberman Mail Sales, P.O. Box 4700, Clifton Park, New York, 12065. And thank you to the United States Postal Service because it arrived a whole day early. All right, thanks much, everybody. Hope you enjoyed it. God bless.